Welcome to the wonderful world of Disney and our special presentation of Walt Disney World, Twas the Night Before Christmas.
Before Christmas, and all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. Uh-huh. Well, maybe one special mouse was stirring. Hey, Mickey, good to see you, big guy. Now, where was I? Oh, yes, lots of creatures were stirring, especially a mouse. All through the kingdom, even though it was night, we were all getting ready to watch Santa's flight. We launched a satellite high in the sky to help us watch as Santa did fly. So we filled the castle with computers and more, and we planned to do something never done before.
Keep up the good work, elves. Say, what's the weather update, Wayne?
Hey, Weather Center reports a cold front forming over Lithuania.
Great job, Wayne. Colin, ETA on Santa?
Roger that.
Yeah?
Santa's airspeed is holding steady. He's right on schedule.
10-4, Colin. Got any news?
He just passed Ivan Blanco's house. The presents have been delivered.
That's great. Now let's see if Ryan's got any updates.
I haven't finished my Christmas shopping
Ryan?
Yet.
Oh,
I know,
Ryan!
I know, I promised, but we're supposed to be tracking
the
Santa.
The show's
tonight.
Begun. Aww.
Sorry, wrong number.
Say, pal, are you ready?
Absolutely, Mickey.
I've been waiting my whole life for a moment like this.
All systems go.
Great!
So, for the first time in history, yes, you heard right, we are going to track Santa's flight. As he flies round the world on top of his sleigh, we will watch Santa all of the way.
Over there, that kind of looks like Santa. Hiya, Santa! just a star. Well, it looked like it.
Tonight, direct from the Walt Disney World Resort in Florida and locations around the globe, it's Walt Disney World, Twas the Night Before Christmas, with continuing coverage of Santa's incredible Christmas Eve flight. Joining us for the celebration at the Disney MGM Studios, rocking around the Christmas tree, Teen Princess Jessica Simpson, and heating up the stage, red hot 98 degrees. From the Magic Kingdom, sister singing sensations, Shadaisy, and incredible young country singing superstar, Billy Gilman. From Disney's Animal Kingdom, the soulful sounds of R&B queen, Monica. Racing the roof at Epcot this Christmas Eve, pop icons NSYNC. From Disneyland in California, our West Coast tracker, Malcolm in the Middle's Frankie Muniz. Now, from Santa Tracking Headquarters, deep inside Cinderella Castle, let's join from Whose Line Is It Anyway? Our Santa trackers for tonight's incredible flight, Wayne Brady, Colin Mockery, and Ryan Stiles.
Ryan.
All right, a little last-minute Christmas shopping on the internet. George Foreman rotisserie. That thing you use to turn off the lights by clapping.
Okay, hey, as Ron was about to tell you, behind me is the STS-1, Santa Tracking System. Tonight, we'll be bringing you minute-by-minute updates on weather conditions around the world and Santa's travels. And for the inside scoop on the man of the hour, my man Santa, we have our own elf expert, Colin.
Happy holidays, everybody. Everything is great. As senior clausologist, I've got the background and insight on Santa, and I'll share some of them with you throughout the night.
We have Santa located right now, just over New Delhi, India.
Oh, he's following the same flight path he took in 87. That was his fastest year ever. Tonight could be a new record.
According to my calculations, taking into account wind speed, reindeer velocity, and what he had for breakfast, he should arrive at the Florida coast in just under 2 hours.
Well, as the elves always say, I'm so excited I feel 4 feet tall.
Colin, I think that was the lights, man.
Tonight's presentation on ABC, brought to you by Diamond of California. You'll love their new glazed walnuts, Tylenol Cold. Take comfort in our strength. And Coca-Cola Classic. Enjoy the holidays.
Welcome back to the wonderful world of Disney.
We're back with Walt Disney World Twas the Night Before Christmas. Please welcome country sensation Billy Gilman.
Pluto's my favorite. We have a bit of a cold front moving in over Portugal. Nothing too serious.
His airspeed is steady at 250 knots. He's looking good up there.
Well, considering the fact that I haven't done my Christmas wrapping yet and it's Christmas Eve, I wonder just how the elves wrap so many presents so quickly. And now I know.
Ryan, we're supposed to be telling them about the STS-1.
Oh, will you go ahead, Wayne? I'm listening.
Okay. Well, it's very simple, really. These computers here receive information from several satellites which are currently in orbit around the Earth. They also receive minute-by-minute reports of Santa sightings from deep in space, ships at sea, highly sophisticated radar tracking stations, eyewitnesses, submarines, jumbo jets, and some girl named Letitia who in junior high teases you because maybe your afro isn't as good as everyone else's. I had a good afro! Oh, and now to our Santa expert, Colin Walker.
Thank you, Wayne. Well, tonight we want to bring you the real stories of Santa. How does Santa make that sleigh fly? Mm. How does he stay warm through all that weather? Mm. And we'll meet the woman behind the great man, Mrs. Claus.
Ah, what a gal. And to keep us updated on breaking Santa news, we have correspondents standing by all over the world.
And from Disneyland, California, our guest correspondent, Frankie Muniz.
Hey, Merry Christmas, everybody. Everything's under control.
Hey, don't forget, Ryan, there's also a spectacular party right here, Christmas Eve, at Walt Disney World tonight. And we won't miss a minute of that. You love parties.
Oh, I love them big time. There's lots of excitement right now over at Disney MGM Studios with everyone set for 98 degrees. And it's hot.
In a sleigh, looking good.
He's right on course.
Right now, from Disney MGM Studios, 98 degrees.
stars are shining like diamonds tonight. And there's no one home. You're finally in my arms again. The night is silent and Christmas is here.
Santa Tracking. Right now, you're looking at Main Street, USA in the Magic Kingdom, where everyone is gathering in anticipation of Santa's arrival here at Walt Disney World. And speaking of arrivals, it looks like another arrival that has everyone excited right now. Here's Snow White joining our Christmas Eve celebration. You know, I've spent my whole life studying all about Santa Claus and his reindeer. I even lived and worked with the elves at the North Pole as one of them until all that crouching finally took its toll on my back and I had to leave. I mean, some days I can barely stand up straight and the cold goes right through. But I guess that's not really important right now. What is important is that in all that time, there were still some questions about Santa that remained a mystery to me until I met a man who explained it all. In a television exclusive, we've got him here with us tonight, Dr. Reginald von Schlump.
Thank you, Colin. By the way, I love your work. Well, Santa and his flying reindeer actually make perfect scientific sense. Now, if you just follow me to this chart, little closer than I thought. Now, in order for the reindeer to fly, the hoof speed over the ground must simply exceed the weight of their antlers in the wind added to the resistance of gravity. This is called bilevitational locomotion, or flying, which, of course, follows the formula x plus 2x minus antlers equals donuts. Which is sort of
hey,
whole thing there.
There's a big storm coming in, a really, really big storm. As you can see by the big red ink that I have on this paper. Ryan.
We have this thing here. Now, to determine Santa's buoyancy in the air, we must use x to the ninth power divided by the weight of his beard minus the number of reindeer, not including Rudolph, unless it's a leaf here.
Guys, look, this thing is moving and the wind speed is increasing. It's about 20 miles outside of Paris, if anyone's listening.
Oh, Paris. I remember when I was there. I love that city. So pretty at Christmas time.
You know, the French have a saying.
What does that mean?
Yeah.
So, with the reindeer, minus the beard, and of course the feet, the style, the hypotenuse.
Oh no, this could be like the great storm of 62 all over again.
So, to sum up, not only do these formulas prove conclusively that Santa's flight is a scientific reality, but they also prove I'm a very, very smart man. I hope this cleared things up for you. Auf Wiedersehen!
Still to come, Frankie Muniz with West Coast Updates and Jessica Simpson.
You're watching The Wonderful World of Disney here on ABC.
We're back with the spectacular Walt Disney World Twas the Night Before Christmas celebration and continuing coverage of the journey of Santa Claus.
Excuse me, Ryan, but I gotta get a hold of my man Frankie over at Disneyland. Go ahead. I gotta have the elves patch him in.
Oh, someone's been reading the manual.
Night school. Frankie, come in. Come in, Frankie.
Gangway, Santa Jack and West coming through here.
Frankie.
Please, highly important Santa Jack and going on here, so please clear a path. That's right. I am the head of the entire Santa Jack and West Coast, so please feel free to be impressed, but please no pictures, especially not in this pose. All right, I really cannot sign any autographs. I mean, I am so busy Santa Jacking here, but here we go. All right, Santa Jacking, here we come. Hey, Merry Christmas, everyone. I'm Frankie Muniz, head of Santa West Coast Tracking. Ah.
Santa Tracking West, this is
Check
Santa Tracking Central. Come in.
Wow.
Santa Tracking West.
This is Santa Tracking... Okay, enough with the names. Frankie, come in.
My mom is watching. Frankie? Frankie!
Yo, West Coast here, what's up?
Have you calculated Santa's arrival time out there in California yet? You remember?
The reason for the mobile tracking unit. The entire West
Coast is counting on you, Frankie.
Should have paid more attention in science class. Or maybe it was math class. I better figure out what time Santa Claus is gonna arrive here. Let's see. But it's just a matter of finding the right button. Oh, now we're onto something. I wonder what this button does. Ah! I got the wrong button! Maybe this will turn it off.
We have a lot of favorite Christmas memories. Growing up, that was like the biggest holiday, and
we celebrate.
We especially appreciate it now as adults because that's the one time of the year we get to go home,
and we all get to actually be together.
We spend usually most of our free time going through old videotapes and 8mm films of all the stuff we used to do as kids, and I think some of the most memorable things are always the Christmas Eve things, mm-hmm. with the bringing down the presents down the stairs and having Dad videotape it.
And the Christmas singing around the piano while my mom plays.
And reading the Christmas story.
Very traditional for us.
Listen to the audience.
They're getting crazy. Oh, yeah.
Great show. That's good.
And now, from the Magic Kingdom, Shabazzy.
Happy Christmas!
Yeah.
Now, you all know Santa is flying into a very dangerous storm. But what you may not know is how prepared Santa is to face the extreme weather. As Santa enters the storm, the temperature will begin to drop rapidly.
Temperature is 31 degrees and falling.
Told ya. But not to worry. Santa is ready. He always carries with him a special thermally heated Santa suit that he can easily slip on over his regular suit if it starts to get cold out. Thank you. Now, my elf friends have brought us a sample of Santa's thermal suit so that I can demonstrate just how easily and quickly Santa can slip it on. Now, Wayne, say you're Santa.
I'm Santa.
And you start to feel a little chilly.
Brr, it is cold out here. I'd better put on my special suit. Ho, ho, ho.
Now, all you have to do is slip your arms in like this.
Colin, I...
Raise your arms up over your head, and the suit will slip right on without you having to take your eyes off the sky for more than a second. Watch. No, it has to slip up. Slip up. You're right. That's how easy it is.
Yeah, see? Easy. Santa has a little bit more experience than I do at this sort of thing.
And he doesn't have a head the size of a Doberman.
What?
You know.
Satellite status, 28 degrees longitude, 20 degrees latitude.
Coming up next, R&B Queen Monica and Jessica Simpson. Plus continuing coverage of Santa's journey with Ryan, Colin, and Wayne.
You're watching The Wonderful World of Disney here on ABC. Now from the Disney MGM Studios, please welcome Jessica Simpson.
Excuse me just a minute while I finish these Christmas cards. Don't you guys have anything to do? Why are you always hanging around me? You gotta get a hobby.
Hey, stop the fighting. Keep your hands to your elf. Look, I've just been running these numbers over again, and it appears that the storm is not changing course. It's gonna hit Disneyland Paris before Santa gets there. Disneyland Paris! Disneyland Paris, come in! This is Wayne at Santa Central. We've had reports of a storm coming your way. How do things look out there?
Bonsoir, bienvenue et joyeux Noël de Disneyland Paris.
Good evening, welcome and Merry Christmas from Disneyland Paris, where we're all anxiously awaiting the arrival of Father Christmas, Père Noël, Santa Claus. But we're not sure whether he will get here before the approaching storm. While the full force of the storm hasn't quite hit us yet, we aren't ruling out severe weather getting here before Santa.
Any chance Santa might have to reroute, possibly delaying his flight until the weather clears? See my accent.
Well, that's a good question, one we put to the children of Europe. We asked them, will bad weather keep Santa away? We got a resounding
no.
Of course not.
Do you think that Santa will make it through the snow?
Of course he will. He's Santa Claus.
Okay, well, people are very sure he's going to make it. Definitely.
Merci, Christian. We'll be sure to keep an eye on the storm for you out there in France.
That's a really big storm. It's bearing down on Paris.
Coming to you from Disney's Animal Kingdom, give a warm welcome to Monica and special guest Plus One.
Welcome back to Santa Central. As you know, Santa delivers presents to every house in the world all in one night, so he's on a pretty tight schedule. After all, there's billions of people in the world. That's a lot of chimneys to squeeze down.
So, Colin, are you saying that if he's delayed by bad weather or problems with his sleigh or freak meteor shower knocks him off course, that he won't make it to every house? Because I find that hard to believe.
Had a lot of caffeine today?
A little, yeah.
All right. Well, he'll make it to every house. He just might have to adjust his ETA. And so far, according to our tracking, Santa's right on schedule. Isn't that right, Wayne?
Absolutely correct, Colin. As you can see on the map, Santa is zipping over Cape Town, South Africa, and he's coming over South Africa. Hey, some room! And if he follows his normal course, he'll whisk all the way around South America and make it up through Switzerland, France, back here to Uruguay, and that's where he could hit some trouble. See? Ooh, it's blowing. But we still expect him here right on time. Get back! Hi-ya!
And we'll stay with this story throughout the night, so stay where you are. We'll be right back. Be careful.
Stay tuned. More Christmas celebrations with NSYNC and Billy Gilman. Don't go away.
Welcome back to the wonderful world of Disney.
Tonight's presentation on ABC, brought to you by Sears. The good life at a great price, guaranteed. By dermatologist-recommended Neutrogena Oil-Free Acne Wash. And K Kellogg's. Tomorrow morning, help yourself with Kellogg's. Welcome back to our continuing coverage of the Flight of Santa Claus.
Santa Central? Santa Central, do you read me? Santa Central, come in, please. Santa Central, this is Morton Brinkley at the Atlantic Santa Sighting Fleet. Do you hear me? Santa Central, do you read me? Santa Central, this is Morton on the Disney Wonder. Are you there? I'm not hearing you, Santa Central. Can you hear me? Do you see me? Am I there?
Guys,
you're not here. Am I there?
It's the Disney Wonder. Wonder, come in.
Well, I'm here on the bridge of the Disney Wonder.
We have assembled our Santa-spotting volunteers. We are awaiting your instructions. Every vessel in our Atlantic Santa sighting fleet is equipped with the same high-tech gear. When Santa flies over, we'll spot him.
Morton, Colin here. Can I have a few words with your Santa spotters?
Captain, could you patch them into the sound system?
Sure. Patched in.
There it is. You're on.
Thanks, Morton. Merry Christmas, everyone.
This is Colin at Santa Central. First, does everyone have their Santa spotting glasses? Excellent, excellent. Next, listening is important, especially that high-pitched bell of Santa's. So carefully cup your hand to your right ear and lean as far as you can to one side.
Excellent. Now you're looking like pros. Finally, pointing is very critical. Look to the sky, raise your hand, and point. Come on, point. That's it. There you have it. Stop, look, listen, and of course, point. Just a little more to the right there, Wayne. Feel the stretch. No, feel the stretch. Feel the pain. More.
Paris no. Storm doesn't look good.
Check on the diamond horseshoe.
Billy's on stage.
Every year, around the second week of December, my brother, my mom, my dad, and I would go out and get our Christmas tree. And no kidding, sometimes it'll take 3 to 4 hours before picking the perfect tree. Like last year, I can remember, the perfect tree turned out to be perfectly too big for our new house. And it made a big, huge scratch on our living room ceiling. My dad wasn't too happy about that, but me and my brother laughed for hours. So, some memories we'll never forget. Especially when we look up.
Sleigh bells ringing, choirs singing, wonder what old Santa's bringing. It's the warm and fuzzy time of year. Snowflakes fall. Families out together shopping. It's the warm and fuzzy time of year. Hell's out.
I'm Wayne Brady, welcoming you back to Main Street USA here at the Magic Kingdom. As you can see, the crowds are packing the streets, eagerly awaiting Santa's arrival this Christmas Eve. Joining the celebration tonight are everyone's favorite toy soldiers from Disney's Babes in Toyland. You know, when I was a kid, I was always trying to catch a glimpse of Santa. Once I thought I actually saw him, but it was a wino. Rhino was actually a lot luckier. He has some pictures to show us.
Hey, yeah, in fact, I have a photo album of all the pictures I tried to take of Santa over the years. This here is a picture of my fireplace just minutes after Santa shot up it. Here's a picture of my roof. This was taken right after Santa flew away. And this next one here, it's one of my favorites. Was I ever that young? It doesn't really have anything to do with Santa, but it's a nice shot of me, don't you think? You know what? Maybe tonight I'll actually meet Santa and thank him for all the presents he's ever given me. It's gonna be a big moment for me. Sorry, I just get a little emotional when I talk about it.
You'll just give us a second, we'll be okay.
Blizzard conditions, but all the elves on storm alert.
Keep tracking the storm's direction.
Up next, pop superstars NSYNC, plus more Santa tracking with Frankie Muniz.
Turn to the wonderful world of Disney's presentation of Twas the Night Before Christmas.
We're back with the spectacular Walt Disney World Twas the Night Before Christmas celebration.
I just gotta figure out what button to push. I guess I'll never figure out what time Santa's gonna get here.
Wow, neat.
So what is it?
It's a highly sophisticated, state-of-the-art Santa tracking mobile unit. You see, I'm tracking the big guy on the ship around the world. I'm the head of the entire Santa tracking. So I'm pretty busy tracking him now, actually.
Sorry.
Oh, no, it's okay. You can help if you want to.
Cool, how do we do that?
Well, we have to determine exactly what time Santa is gonna arrive here.
And how do we do that?
Well, you see, this screen gives us the data and yeah, well, it's actually very complicated, so.
See, I bet you program in Santa's current location, rate of speed, course, hours left, factor in the number of houses. I got it. Santa arrives here at 1:22 a.m. Am I right?
Santa Central, West Coast here. I figured out Santa's arrival time for California.
Hey, good work, Frankie. What's the ETA?
Exactly 1:22 a.m.
Wow, very precise, Frankie. I knew we could count on you.
Thanks. Gotta go now. So.
I gotta go.
Well, I could take you guys on some rides no one's ever been on before at Disney's California Adventure Park.
That doesn't open until February.
I've got the keys.
At Walt Disney World, let's give a big Christmas welcome to NSYNC.
Is everybody having a good time?
Woo! Ooh, Merry Christmas, happy holiday.
Merry Christmas.
Oh, yeah. The snow is glistening on the trees outside, and all the stockings are hung by my fireside, waiting for a Santa to arrive, and all the love will show, cause everybody knows it's Christmas time, and all the kids will see the gifts under the tree. It's the best time of year for the family. Your holiday,
it's a time to celebrate.
Put your worries aside. Open up your mind.
Open up your
mind. The world right by your side. It's Christmas.
Come on, pass the game. Come on.
Christmas and happy holidays. Thank you very much.
Christian Brewster at Disneyland Paris with an update.
The snow is now coming down very hard. It's getting cold and extremely windy. The storm is getting worse and worse. Even the airports have told us that planes are being rerouted due to poor visibility. All of this, of course, begs the question, is Santa prepared to face the storm?
Well, that's a good question, Christian. Now, just a few weeks ago, we were lucky enough to get a sneak peek behind the scenes of Santa's testing facilities at the North Pole, where his trusty sleigh is put through its paces in preparation for its Christmas Eve flight. Take a look. Now, this may look like just an ordinary entrance to an ordinary cave where ordinary elves are going through their ordinary jobs. Ordinarily, you'd be right. But these elves belong to the Santa sleigh testing team, and there's nothing ordinary about that. Deep under the earth in a top-secret lab, these elves have designed a series of rigorous tests to make sure that Santa's sleigh is ready for its night-long journey around the world. First, the sleigh is subjected to extreme weather conditions, ranging from subarctic temperatures to scalding desert heat. The sleigh is carefully watched, making sure that not even the slightest defect is present. Nothing must prevent the sleigh from performing its task. But the tests don't stop here. Other conditions are tested as well, such as rain and hurricane-force winds. Nothing is left to chance. Turbulence tests, high-speed impact tests, and more are performed as the sleigh is pushed, prodded, and pummeled in every conceivable way. When that sleigh is done here, these elves are confident that it can handle anything Santa or Mother Nature has to throw at it. As you can see, it passed all its tests with flying colors. Let me tell you, this is one tough little sleigh.
Wow, he's making great time.
Check the XM4 satellite. Santa's altitude is steady.
Coming up next, more excitement with 98 degrees, plus continuing coverage of Santa's flight when we return.
You're watching The Wonderful World of Disney here on ABC.
Welcome back to Walt Disney World, Twas the Night Before Christmas. From Disney MGM Studios, 98 Degrees.
Hey guys, isn't this a great time of year, Christmas?
Yeah.
I remember one year when Jude and I were little kids, we snuck down from our bedrooms late at night thinking we were going to see Santa Claus come down the chimney.
It was Nick's idea.
Except no, our dad found out we were down there and he came and made us go to bed. And ruined the whole thing, yeah.
Our dad used the same tree 2 years in a row. But it wasn't an artificial tree, it was a live tree.
It was a real tree.
He used it 1 year, and it wasn't a good-looking tree the first year. So we decorated and everything, then he threw it down in the woods behind the house, and then the next year, he didn't feel like going out and getting another tree. So he just went out, pulled it back out of the woods, stuck it back up.
We come in the door, and there's this little skeleton of a tree with a few dead needles hanging off of it.
And like four ornaments.
Did you decorate it?
Did the whole popcorn thing and everything.
Oh, that's recycling.
Yeah. At its best.
Hi, I'm Ryan Stiles here at Walt Disney World, where our Christmas Eve celebration is in full swing. People are crowding the streets hoping to catch a glimpse of Saint Nick when he arrives. Oh, and here comes more of our special guests tonight. There's Chip and Dale and their bake shop friends.
Ah, the cookies. There's something I know a little something about.
Santa's entered France. He's heading towards Paris. It's getting worse. Lots of snow, lots of ice, winds at 40 miles an hour.
It's okay. Santa's sleigh has been tested and winds up to 100 miles an hour. I think he's going to be fine.
Uh-oh. Wind speed picking up. 60 miles an hour. Now it's 70.
Or he could have to reroute. This doesn't look good.
Clock's still ticking. He should be here in just about an hour. Now, once he hits France and England, he jets across the Atlantic. Boom, where's next stop?
Unless he's forced to reroute around the storm.
Oh, come on, Tanner, you can do it!
Santa Central, over here is Tokyo Disneyland.
Over there, you're coming in loud and clear. Go right ahead.
Hello and Merry Christmas from Tokyo Disneyland, where it is already Christmas morning. Santa has already come and gone, leaving presents under trees everywhere. But this year, he may have left something more. A major new find in scientific study of Santa Claus and his flight.
Mysterious tracks that seem to end as if whatever made them took flight. Scientific proof of Santa's journey We asked reindeer expert Dr. Tonakai Hakase for his professional opinion on whether or not these trucks were made by flying reindeer.
In my professional opinion, these trucks are made by flying reindeer.
But did just any flying reindeer make these trucks? Or could they be the actual hoof prints left behind by Santa's team? Something Dr. Hakase discovered may hold the answer.
We discovered some surprising information, he says, Dasher.
Whoa!
Reindeer hoof prints, Dasher's sleigh bell, presence everywhere. Scientific evidence or simple coincidence, you be the judge.
That's amazing, Dasher's actual sleigh bell. Are you guys still looking for evidence?
We are looking all night long. As a matter of fact, we are tracking down reports that someone actually caught Santa on tape, and we'll be getting back to you with that story as soon as we can.
Hey Ryan, check this out. We've got visitors. Oops! Shadaisy!
When you said yesterday that it's nearly Christmas, what did I want? And I thought, just love me.
Santa hit the storm. He's flying right into it.
How's he looking?
It's hard to tell. I mean, he still looks okay, but the worst is still yet to come. Temperatures are dropping rapidly. It's already well below zero out there.
All right, don't worry. Santa is going to be just fine. He's faced this sort of thing before. He knows how much he can handle. You know, I'm really glad we can see him on the tracking system. I mean, if we weren't able to track him, he could get delayed by the storm. We'd never know. Oh, thanks, Stretch. Oh, anybody else want some cocoa? The elves made it from their special recipe. You know, they don't use water. They use melted snow.
Melted snow?
Yeah. Come on. Mmm! Oh! These elves make one tasty cup of cocoa.
Come on.
You can't drink cocoa around the equipment. This stuff is very delicate. The slightest spill could wreck everything.
Well, they made you a cup, too.
They sprinkle it with marshmallows the way I like?
They certainly did.
Thanks. Mmm, cocoa.
Can the Santa tracking system be fixed in time to find Santa? Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Welcome back to the wonderful world of Disney.
We're back with continuing coverage of the journey of Santa Claus.
The tracking center is down. I repeat, the tracking center is down.
We've lost Santa. Backups aren't responding.
All right, try emergency lighting.
But, okay.
Okay, right, that's better. Now, what do we got that's working?
The weather center is still up, and we still have contact with our correspondents.
Okay, all right, this isn't so bad.
Okay.
All right, no one panic. Everything okay, all right? There is nothing to worry about. Well,
Actually, Santa's flying into a really bad storm, and we have no way of knowing if he's going to be delayed or not.
All right. Scratch what I said before. Now is the time to panic. Everyone panic! Now is the time to panic!
Okay, Elf! Yeah, we gotta fix this thing! Come on!
Man, I don't believe this. I waited my whole life for the chance to see Santa in action, and then poof, it's just gone. All because of one cup of hot, delicious cocoa. I don't deserve this. I came so close to seeing Santa. Now it's all just slipping away.
All right, everyone, just back up. Give us some space to work.
Space to work. Space to work. Space.
Skeleton.
No. No. What are you talking about? Space. That's it. Space shuttle. Space shuttle, come in. This is Santa Central. Our Santa tracking system has gone down. Can you help us find Santa? Space shuttle, I see you. Can you read me?
This is Commander Story Musgrave, aboard the Space Shuttle Explorer. Santa Central, we read you loud and clear.
And this is Pilot Greg Johnson. We've had a confirmed Santa sighting aboard the shuttle just 2 minutes ago, and we're continuing to track him on radar.
Wait a minute, he was aboard the shuttle? Commander, are you sure it was Santa?
There's no mistaking that red suit. It was him, all right.
And look, we all got presents.
Stand by, Santa Central. We are sending you his coordinates right now. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you, guys. Merry Christmas to you. And hey, can you check to see if I left the lights on at my house? Wait, did you get those coordinates? I'm on it.
I have nothing to say.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire. Jack Frost nipping at your nose. Yuletide carols being sung by a choir. And knows a turkey and some mistletoe helps to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all ablaze. Every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know. It's been said many times, many ways. Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas to you.
Thank you.
According to the coordinates that the astronauts gave us, Santa is right about there, 1 hour outside of Paris. Christian, are you there? Hello, Christian.
We haven't spotted him yet. He should have been here by now. If he doesn't show up soon, wait a minute. I hear something. I think it's sleigh bells. Yes, it is sleigh bells. Oh, I think.
Hey, Christian, I'm sorry. Can you say that again? I couldn't hear you over the static. Your transmission is really bad. I can't hear him.
I understand him. He's saying
does anybody speak reindeer? Christian, what's that? We've almost lost it. Hey,
wait. They're eating all the technology.
Christian.
Santa, right. This is the most incredible thing I've ever seen. Wasn't it amazing? I didn't think anything like this was physically possible. It was everything I always dreamed it would be. Well, he made it through the storm, and he was incredible. What do you think?
There are no words.
Oh, you're so right. Well, this wraps it up from Disneyland Paris. Joyeux Noël. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Chateau Nouveau.
Hey. My Christmas tree lights are out.
Hey, we're back online, all right. Yes! Hey, guys, let's not miss him again, all right?
Hey. Let's put all of our Atlantic Santa sighting fleet on alert. When Santa passes them, I want to know about it. Ryan, send out the signal.
We've received the alert from Santa Central.
We have received the alert from Santa Central.
It's time to start the announcement.
It's time to start the announcement.
Attention, all Santa spotters, report to your stations. Red alert, this is not a drill.
Well, as you can well imagine, the anticipation is building by the second here aboard the Disney Wonder. We are ready. When Santa flies over, don't you worry, we'll spot him. You can count on that.
All right, everybody. It looks like we're as ready as we can be. I guess all we can do now is wait.
The storm is getting bigger. Rudolph's nose will help. How's he doing? Going strong. Nose at brightest level.
Stay tuned. Up next, a sneak peek at Disney's new California Adventure Park with Frankie Muniz.
You're watching The Wonderful World of Disney here on ABC.
Coming to you from Disney's Animal Kingdom, give a warm welcome to Monica.
Hang all the mistletoe, I'm gonna get to know you better. This Christmas, and as we trim the tree, how much fun it's gonna be together. This Christmas, fireside blazing bright, we'll be caroling through the night. And this Christmas will be a very special Christmas from me, yeah. Clap your hands. So fireside blazing.
I'm Wayne Brady, and you are watching the huge Santa celebration that's taking place right now out on Main Street, USA, right here at the Magic Kingdom. Now, I don't know if you can feel it, but there's an excited buzz in the air down there as Santa's arrival gets closer and closer. And we've got great news. Santa has cleared the storm. He made it all the way through, and he's out over the ocean now. It looks like clear flying from here on out.
Well, that's great, Wayne. He should be right on schedule. Right now, we'd like to learn a little more about Santa. Here's Colin with an exclusive interview with Mrs. Claus, direct from the North Pole. Colin?
Thanks, Ryan.
Mrs. C. Mrs. C, are you there?
Yes, I'm here, dear. It's so nice to see you again, Colin. How's the back?
Oh, you know, it still gives me a little twinge when I crouch, but otherwise it's fine.
Well, that's good to hear. So what can I do for you?
Well, Mrs. Claus, shed a little light on Santa Claus. How did the two of you meet?
I first saw Santa at a dance in Akron, Ohio, long, long time ago. You know, he's quite a good dancer.
If you had to pick a favorite thing about Santa, what would it be?
Oh, his sense of humor. He loves to laugh.
Now, Santa goes by a lot of names. Kris Kringle, Father Christmas, Papa Noel, Santa, Bobanta. What do you call him?
Well, I just call him Santa, or sometimes Honey Bunny.
Well, thanks for talking to us, Mrs. Claus. It's been a pleasure.
Oh, the pleasure has been all mine, Colin. Bye-bye now, and Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas, Mrs. Claus. Very cool, Colin. And right now, let's check back with our West Coast tracker, Frankie Muniz.
Check it out. See, I told you I can get us in. Hey, see these letters? You know they were going to make them really small, but I said, hey, how about making them really big instead? Isn't this place great? Disney's California Adventure Park. Where do you see this place?
Frankie, I can't see anything. It's too dark in here.
Yeah, I know it's dark, but I know there's a light switch around here somewhere. Ah. Wow.
Wow.
Look at all the lights. They're beautiful.
Wow, this sun wheel is huge.
This is so cool.
Here's my concept. Isn't that awesome?
That's really cool.
Look.
That's
cool. Cool whitewater rafting.
Here we go.
How about riding on a hang glider?
Sounds like fun. The monorail! Maybe you really are in charge. Let's head back to the pier.
Why not try a looping roller coaster? Let's say we hit the Ferris wheel. Well, this is the life.
Yeah, for a bird.
The Ferris wheel, it's stopping.
Help, anybody!
Oh, great.
It's me,
stuck.
Frankie! Come on, I have the keys.
We're
I don't know if anybody can get in, but help!
Frankie!
Anybody?
Frankie, there? West Coast, come in. Frankie, are you goofing off again? I'll put you in the middle. Hey, look, if he doesn't pay attention, he's gonna miss the arrival. Frankie?
Right now, from Disney MGM Studios, 98 Degrees.
Spirit pulls me through when nothing.
Still to come, Santa Countdown. Plus, more Billy Gilman and Shadaisy.
I say that this is the most appropriate wave for when Santa flies by.
Mm-hmm.
Santa Central!
Hello.
Santa Central, I'm not reading you. Santa is here.
Not bad, but I think something a little more hip like this.
Hello, Santa. Is this thing on? Am I getting it? Santa Central!
You know what? I think we should do something that I like to call, hey, what's up?
Wait a minute. Okay, here it is. Okay, check this out.
Santa is here now.
Oh. That's nice.
That's good.
It's good. It's scary when you do it.
Yeah, when he does it, it's hip yet respectful. When you do it, it's just plain.
I'll pull back a bit.
No, it's still you. Want to scare the kids. It's Christmas.
Well, we're just trying to get Santa.
That's funny.
Oh, all right. Very funny.
No, it wasn't. That's what it was.
Maybe you could stick to the hip one you were doing.
Maybe have like a combo.
He's
guys, the cruise ship has spotted Santa.
He's just going to be a prick. Hey, we hear you, Martin. We hear you. What's going on? Martin, we hear you!
As we celebrate Santa's arrival here, I'm sure the big guy himself is heading towards Walt Disney World and you! When you see him, tell him thanks for all of this! Martin Brinkley, the Disney Wonder, Merry Christmas, one and all!
Wow.
Well, that's great. We miss Santa again. You know what? A weaker Santa tracker might give up right now. The word quit might come to mind, but no. I am strong. We will not fail. I ask you, are we men or are we mice?
Make that mouse, Ryan. We won't give up. It's okay, guys.
Hey, Mickey.
Oh, gosh.
Hey, you know what?
Oh.
I have a feeling that you're going to bring us luck, huh?
You betcha,
Just
Ryan.
A few more minutes by my count. Hey, come on. We can do it,
you're
huh?
Ready.
Come on.
Hey, Mickey!
Huh?
Okay, that's just scary. Oh. 2.5 minutes and counting. Santa is nearing the coast.
He's almost here. He's almost here. Elves, man your stations. Up your stations. Get to your stations. He's almost here.
Oh, excuse me. Great. All right. We need someone to go outside, get the crowd ready. Mickey, can you help?
I'll do it, Wayne.
Great. Thanks, Mickey. All right. Just
here
minutes
go.
To go.
Oh, boy. This is going to be so exciting. Gosh, I can't wait to see Santa. Merry Christmas, everybody. All ready for Santa.
The moment we've been waiting for. Santa arrives at Walt Disney World. Don't go away. Tonight's presentation on ABC brought to you by Zocor. Talk to your doctor about Zocor today. Saturn, now with two distinctively different car lines, the L Series and S Series. And Walt Disney Pictures' Emperor's New Groove, now playing at a theater near you.
Oh my gosh, he's almost here. He's almost here.
This is the moment that I have been waiting for all my life. I'm gonna actually meet Santa. Uh-oh. I'm so excited, I've actually forgotten how to breathe.
Oh, wait, now I remember. Whew, that was a close one. Santa's here,
Santa's here.
And you know why? Because we tracked him. No one else has tracked him.
Oh, the Yeti, Bigfoot, but we
guys,
got Santa.
Guys, calm down. I know this is a pretty exciting time, but that's just-
20 seconds.
20 seconds. 20 seconds. 20 seconds, he's here, Santa's here. This is unbelievable, this is amazing.
Wait for being calm?
Calm, how can you stay calm? This is Santa, the Santa, Father Christmas, Santa, Bull Banta.
Wow, I didn't realize he had that many names.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, everyone, let's all get together. He's almost here, okay? Now let's count it down together, all right? Everybody ready?
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
From the Disney family to yours, warmest wishes for the holiday season.
Tuesday, the best of Whose Line Is It Anyway kicks off a marathon week. It's part of five whole nights of Whose Line Is It Anyway, starting Tuesday at 10, 9 Central on ABC.